Today I left the port of Southampton on the Whistler Downs for the Charles River. Anyways, tomorrow I will head north into the woods. They call it the Notch of Mountains. Yours truly, your son, Frederick Strickland. Perfect. It's only 10 p.m. Oh. Well, then best get go. So, gloves, one scarf, let's just do two scarves. It'd be good to have some variation. And one long coat, that should be enough. And Crawford House, here it is. Dream a little dream of me.
Stars fading, but I linger on, dear.
Oh, how you linger on.
Still craving your kiss.
How you crave my kiss.
Now I'm longing.
Till sunbeams find you, sweet dreams that leave all.
Nothing I can't do.
What in your dreams, whatever they be.
Okay, got to go. Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory for ever. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Just clean up the stuff and go to sleep. Still too bitter. Much better. I never could sleep without you, could I?
Hello, sir. How may I help you?
Abel Crawford?
Yes, that's me. And you are?
Oh, Frederick Strickland, sir. I've just come up from Boston.
Ah, I see. Did you get advice from someone?
Why, yes. George Bond and Arnold Guyot said they'd been up here this summer and they recommended a visit to me.
Ah, Harvard boys.
Yes. Do you know I might find some hiking up here? Just for fun.
Well, I doubt you'd want to take the path.
Sorry, what's the path?
The Crawford path, Mr. Strickland.
Ah, yes, the Crawford path, I see now. How difficult is it?
Well, you definitely wouldn't want to go the full length to Mount Washington. But the hike up the tree line's quite nice. There are some good views from up there.
Ah, okay. How long is it?
About 6 miles round trip. I'll tell you this. Just go up the notch a little ways more, and you'll come upon the notch house. I believe Thomas is up there right now. He could give you some advice.
Very well. Thank you, sir.
Safe travels.
Your brother Abel just sent me up here and said you could give me some recommendations on some hiking trails.
Ah, well, you seem young enough and strong enough to hike some good trails around here. Where are you originally from, Mr. Strickland?
England, Mr. Crawford. From Bridlington.
Ah, okay. So how long have you been here for?
A few weeks. I steamed here with my brother and stayed in Boston for a while.
Ah, very good.
I see there's not much business here currently.
No, there isn't. It gets pretty quiet up here in the winter time. There's a nice cliff just a mile and change away from here that has some nice good views of the notch. And that would be nice if you want a good entry level hike. Webster's cliffs wouldn't be suitable in poor weather. But you could go to the peak just to the left of that.
Would your Crawford path be suitable?
Oh, wow. The area below the timberlines could be suitable, but the ridge beyond that could be too dangerous this time of year.
Would there be horse guides I could sign on?
Yes, I suppose we could have an escort. I'll have them come right now. However, Mr. Strickland, if you do go the full length, from Mount Clinton to Mount Washington, please take a path back. You'd be better suited on old Horace Fabian's bridle path. You can follow along the river to his hotel. I can have your bike sent there if you prefer that option.
Thank you for your advice, Mr. Crawford. That option sounds fine to me.
Once you get above the timberlines, if it's foggy, please follow the cairns.
Absolutely.
What a nice trail this is, I say. If I make it to the top of Mount Washington, do you think I should come down this way?
No, I think Favian's path is a better trail. But I might ask, why are you going to Mount Washington?
Oh, well, Mr. Crawford said it'd be a nice climb, and I just thought I'd do it while I was up here.
Are you ready to go, or do you want to go back down?
No, let's keep going. Snow. Not good. Mr. Strickland!
What is it? What?
Sir, we have to turn back. The snow is getting too deep.
What? No, that is completely out of the question. The summit is right there. There is no snow up there.
Mr. Strickland, soon we will be completely above the timberline and completely exposed to these winds. Do you understand where we are?
I'm going on. If you want to go back, you go right ahead.
Mr. Strickland, please, don't be a fool!
I did not come from England to Boston to New Hampshire to here to not summit what mountain. If you think I'm a damn old fool, then that's fine. I'm going. Damn idiot.
Come on, Mr. Strickland. Make it down safely.
Thank you.
Fabyan.
Any visitors off of Mount Washington yesterday?
Wait a second. Was he expecting this?
So I'm guessing he's not here.
No, I didn't get anyone in yesterday. Wait, did you say Washington? He was on Washington?
Yes, he wants up our path, and I told him not to go past Clinton, but he went all the way up anyways.
He was unprepared, went into the storm, went all the way up to the summit, against all the advice of my guides.
Now the guides tell me that he's planning to go down your bridle path for his descent.
Oh, good God!
Thomas!
What?
Just stop for a minute.
Why?
Someone just came down off of Washington.
Oh.